A struct is a popular custom data type for grouping related values. In this video, I'll explain the different types of structs, how to use them, and the methods and functions to specify a struct's data. A struct is a type that's composed of other types. Like tuples, the pieces of a struct can be different types, but you can name each piece of data so it's clear what the values mean. Because each field is named, structs are more flexible than tuples. Structs and rest come in three flavors. There are classic structs, tuple structs, and unit structs. Classic C structs are the most commonly used. Each field defined within them has a name and a type. Tuple structs are similar to classic structs, but their fields have no names. And unit structs have no fields. They are called unit-like because they behave similarly to the unit type. The unit type has exactly one value. It is used when there are no other meaningful values that can be returned. To define a struct, the keyword struct is used, followed by the name of the struct. The name should describe the object appropriately so that it relates to the data being grouped together. An example of a classic struct that you see here is to define a car object and then group the related attributes, which are make, model, and year. Notice that make and model are of type string, and year is an unsigned integer, that is 32 bits. And then to use the struct after we've defined it, we create an instance of the struct by supplying the key value pairs, where keys are the names of the fields and values are the data that we store in those fields. So to instantiate the car struct, we could do the following. Inside of the main function, we'll go ahead and declare a new variable called car1 by saying let car1, and that is going to be equal to the car struct. So then inside of that, we can specify the attributes about the car like this. We define a specific make, which is a string with Ford as the value. We define a model, which is also a string with Mustang as the value. And then finally, we define a year. And going forward, I can create more instances of the struct in the same way by supplying a unique name and a new set of key value pairs. Next, we would be able to get specific values from a struct by using the dot notation. For example, if I wanted to know the year of car one, I can say car1.year and receive the value of 1967 back. So that should give you a high-level overview of how structs are used. Next up, join me for a demo to see more examples of structs in action and get a better idea how to use them in your programs.